From the Department of Urology, Lakeshore Hospital, Kochi, India, we are presenting a video demonstration of our technique of laparoscopic pyeloplasty in infant. A 3-month-old female child presented with worsening of antenatally detected hydronephrosis. Ultrasound and MR urogram revealed a right hydronephrosis with impaired drainage, suggestive of a right pelvic-ureteric junction obstruction. Diuretic renogram also revealed a prolonged drainage pattern. She was planned for a laparoscopic pyeloplasty through transperitoneal approach. A preoperative retrograde urogram confirmed a narrow right pelvic-ureteric segment of about 2.5 cm. 5 ports were utilized. The port positions are depicted in the illustration. The pneumoperitoneum was maintained at 10 mm of mercury. After colonic mobilization, the lower pole of the kidney was delineated. Dissection was then continued caudally, identifying the right ureteral course. The right ureter was dissected cranially and the pelvic-ureteric segment was approached. Usage of thermal energy was intentionally restricted during ureteral mobilization. The pelvis was freed of all adhesions and the pelvic-ureteric junction was demarcated. During pelvic mobilization, usage of thermal energy was also restricted. The abnormal segment was delineated and we planned to conduct a dismembered pyeloplasty. The ureter was dismembered immediately distal to the pathological segment. The ureter was patulated in posterolateral direction till mucosal pouting and attainment of a satisfactory caliber. Although the pathological segment appeared to have a good caliber, no peristaltic activity was detected. Also, there was no urine efflux from the dismembered end. This is crucial in decision making as the entire segment needs to be excised in this case for satisfactory restoration of pelvic-ureteric drainage. The ease of approximation of the upper ureter to the dilated pelvis was ascertained, and being a dilated system, we could easily achieve the approximation. In other situations where the distance between the severe ends is considerable, our practice is to mobilize the entire renal unit with descensus of the renal unit to overcome the defect. The pelvis is patulated till the most dependent part. The pelvic-ureteric approximation is then conducted employing 4-0 polyglectin suture. The corner stitch is employed first, uniting the spatulated end of the ureter to the lowermost point of the pelvis. This is followed by approximating the opposite corner of the anastomosis. The pelvic margin is freshened prior to approximating the other end. Following this, the posterior layer of the anastomosis is conducted using interrupted suture of 4-0 polyglectin. After completion of the posterior layer, the anterior layer of anastomosis is undertaken. In this case, the pelvis was grossly enlarged and excess pelvis was excised. After taking the first stitch of the anterior layer of anastomosis, we insert a ureteral stent in an anti-grid fashion. Our technique of stent placement involves insertion of a percutaneous puncture needle through which a guide wire is inserted along the ureter. The tract is then dilated using a Teflon dilator followed by passage of a ureteral stent along the guide wire. The upper end of the stent is directed towards the pelvis under direct vision. Thereafter, the anterior layer of pelvi-ureteric approximation is continued using interrupted sutures of 40 polyglectin. This was followed by closure of the excised pelvis in a continuous fashion. Following completion of anastomosis, hemostasis is ensured, a drain is placed and ports closed. She had an uneventful recovery. Stent was removed 6 weeks post-procedure. Till last follow-up, she is asymptomatic. Thank you.